advice to tell the resident physician that once she left, she was going to stay with her sister in Connecticut. NYC health officials were wrong about Mary. Although she killed many people, she never knew about it. They treated Mary wrong because many other people had typhoid in their system but weren't sent in quarantine for life. Mallon was forced to give urine and stools when they should have sent her down and calmly explained.
She shouldn't be locked in quarantine because they forced her to take meds so she would be free. The doctors before she was offered meds didn't want to be bothered with her, but they are trying to cure her. This doesn't seem right. They could have poisoned the meds to give to her so she would die and this whole thing would be over. Also, they were holding her against her will. She wasn't sick or needed any treatment, so why was she there? She wasn't ill or never had been ill.
Also, she didn't know she was giving a disease to people. She just wanted a job. The whole thing was a big accident. But she was held against her will, and she was forced to get samples and held her in quarantine. She wasn't comfortable with that living, and they knew that.
We believe that Mary Mallon is a villain because she killed 8 people, disobeyed the directions of the police when the police asked her to do. She should have been in quarantine, but she changed her name, but still got me.
Also, she refused to give samples so that the officers would know what was going on and find a cure. I also believe that Mary Mallon should have been in quarantine because she tried to put up a fight with the pitchfork while she was cooking. The tuberculosis man called her the kidnapper.
I do believe too for Mary's villain because she disregarded the respect for the citizens of New York by going back to school after she was found a different job away from cooking area. And then she cooked in a hospital with 25 cases and 2 deaths.
Good. All right.
We're arguing about how you said they were treating her wrong. They were treating her wrongly, then they would have been like tugging her out of her house. But Mary Mallon, she put up her own fight, and she was trying to tug away, pushing, and she was throwing things, and she was in the kitchen the first time she saw them. So I don't understand how you guys are saying that she cheated, how they treated her wrongly, and she cheated them wrongly by trying to put up a fight.
The second time they let her go, she had another job, but the second time she got out, she knew she was spreading typhoid fever because they ran tests, and it was negative and positive, but it was mostly positive. And she went out, and she changed her name, but it was illegally, so she actually committed a crime. Second time, the cops actually had a right to arrest her, but they just sent her back to the island.
Okay.
We're arguing because y'all said that she disobeyed the directions of the police. She did not disobey the directions of the police because she was scared. People came into her house and, like, frightened her. Because her name was all over newspapers, journals, everywhere. And she had the right.
Okay, so back to, you all said that she put up a fight with a fork. She put up a fight with a fork because she was scared and she was trying to protect herself from the police. Because people were coming in and out of her face, in and out of her
sick, you're getting people sick, you're killing people, and such things like that. Also, she wanted to, well, she put up a fight with Pitchfork because they should have at least talked to her in a nice, calm manner instead of just ambushing her. Instead of forcing their way into her space, according to Amendment 4, they should have had a good reason or a warrant.
You said that she refused the samples, but she was afraid and felt like she was being ambushed when she got the samples because she was uncomfortable and she was like, didn't know what's going on when she had the samples. So she was like disobeying it. She was like, I'm perfectly healthy. What are you doing? That's the
doctors, before the doctors offered meds, they didn't want to be bothered with her, and so, like, now they're trying to come up with a cure to fix her with the medicine. They could have put poisons in the medicine to get to Mary Mallon so she would die because at first they didn't want to be bothered with her.
Good job.
Remember when you said she changed her job from, it was you or Christopher, Christopher, when you said why did she change her job? She changed her job for the money. Being a laundress didn't really get enough pay, but as a cook, she got a lot of pay, and even though she had a second chance, she still needed money to survive and to live off.
Alright. Hassan, anything?
They might have treated her different because she was an Ireland immigrant. Like, they would like treat her like differently because she was an Ireland immigrant and like she was from another place. She wasn't from the USA. She wasn't from where she was at. And like the USA, she was from a different country, and she was treated differently than others. Cause the other people had typhoid fever, and they didn't get kept captive, and they're from the USA. But Mary Mallon had typhoid fever, and she was kept under her will in quarantine.
Okay.
She all ambushed her, like attacked her, and like how you said they treated her wrongly. It's sort of if they would have ambushed her, then they, without knowing, then they would just be busting through the door, and then saying, "Hey, you have typhoid fever. You need to come with us. That means be in quarantine."
Time and she again angrily refused. So they would have to force her to give the samples because she wouldn't be able to be, to, they wouldn't be able to create a cure for all the other carriers, and all the other people who were sick and had a chance to be cured.